Hi guys, so this is my, I don't know which attempt to make this video. It's just going completely out of hand. I'm trying to make a small video of my May wrap up of the books that I read and give you mini reviews, but instead I just seem to go on and on. Oh, it's very difficult. But anyways, I read around 10 books. Let's do this fast. I read around 10 books. Three of these were requested from NetGalley, which is a boon to all of us. And then six of them I read on my own, out of which three were a series. I'd like to read my series in sequence, and when I can get my hands on them, yeah. And then one was a book club read, and which I read for our book club, local book club here. So let's begin. So I'll begin with the first. I will begin with the NetGalley reads. Okay, let's do that. So the first book is Lies Behind the Ruin by Helen Mattews. Now, lies behind, the word play in this is really nice. Once I got into the book, I realized that, oh, okay, the author has been very clever with the words. I like that always. So this is a story. This is a very contemporary novel. I'm not very much into contemporary, but yes, I did enjoy this book. It was a good time pass. So, and I thought that the book took a new look at that movie, remember Fatal Attraction? Yeah, it was not, it's not as gory as that, but yes, it does have very strong elements of it. So there is this couple who are very happily married, they've got one kid, and then there is the wife's kid from an earlier marriage, previous marriage, and everything is going hunky-dory. And then something happens at work, and the man Paul, he starts sort of unraveling, you know, making one lie after the another, and just ruins the whole family. So it moves from between from Britain to France, and then in France, then there's a lot of description of the French countryside, and it seems more set in France to me. At the end of the book, I was, you know, for me it was a French book, sort of like set in France. I liked it, and it's also described as domestic noir, because you know there is this dark sort of theme, underlying theme to it. You can call it a thriller also, but yes, I like the suspense. I like the way the author treated this subject, and it was a pretty fun read. So yes, thumbs up for that one. Then of course there was one for the Blackbird and one for the Crow by Olivia Slacker. Okay, I can't read my own handwriting. I've written stuff here and I can't read my own handwriting. Oh my god, this is just sad. So anyways, so this is a book, Olivia Hawker. What have I written? My God. Anyways, one for the Blackbird and one for the Crow. So this is about two families who are living out in Wyoming in 1870. And the descriptions, you know, you can just see that vast expanse of land, you know, with not a human being in sight, which is just impossible for us to imagine as Indians, you know, to see this huge expanse and nobody, you know, even if you go to the Himalayas, you'll probably. So the descriptions of the countryside, of the places, are so beautiful. I don't know how people do that. It's lovely. And the story is about these two farmsteads which are next door to each other, and the family, Bemis and Weber families. So what happens that the Bemis, Ernest Bemis, his wife Cora Bemis is having an affair with the, what is his name, you know, the Weber guy, and then the husband finds them and he shoots Mr. Weber, and then goes to jail, and that leaves Cora alone with her daughter Beluha and her little kids, not Beluha's little kids, Cora's little kids. And in the other household, there's just Mrs. Weber, who's Nettie May, and her son. And now her son and Beluha are the same age. And what happens is now, because both the men have gone, and it is a very harsh winter that they must survive, so they must join forces. And then these two women, who one would expect will not be able to look at each other in the eye, are just forced to, you know, live in the same house, so that they can survive the winter. It's a premise which just makes you think, you know, you sometimes really think, wonder where authors come up with these ideas. So, And of course, then there is the bit of that magical realism thing with the magic and Veluha, and she can see things and stuff like that and whatever. But I thought the book was, it did keep me engrossed. I must say that, yes, I did find it to be engrossing for me, because these are not genres that I would pick up early, but yes. So I would say one for the Blackbird and one for the Crow is a good read. I cannot immediately think of some book which would compare with it, but yes, it is a good piece of American literature set in Wyoming and a great nature read. And yes, the third book is Song of Sacrifice by Janelle Rhiannon. This I read almost at the end of April, okay? But this is like the retelling of Odysseus. Yes. So I mean, we have read Circe in last year and everybody loved it and it was great. I wish this book had come before that. I actually enjoyed this book a lot more. It brought, you know, it took, like, whenever you think of Helen of Troy, there is always Helen as this beautiful, frail beauty who is just, you know, who has been rescued from an evil king and stuff like that. Here it's not like that. Here we begin with the story of Paris, you know, who brings her home. And I didn't know there was this whole history behind Paris. Obviously there would have been, but he's always delegated to the background. But here we read about Paris and Achilles. Achilles has this whole, you know, other kind of world. I would say, definitely say, that the female characters in this book took a little backseat to the male characters, which is fine. You know, once in a while you do want to read a little male-centric kind of books, which happened this month. I read, I think, two books which are like that. Yes, one is Song of Sacrifice and one is another, The Cutting for Stone. So I really enjoyed this book. I think it's a great read as an introduction to Greek mythology, even better than Circe, because, you know, once you read this, you can get into the mood, better understanding of the whole Greek world. So definite yes to 5 stars to Song of Sacrifice. And that is it with my NetGalley reads. So then let's begin with French Exit. Have I done it already? Oh my god, I have recorded so many times that I can't even remember. So I'll just go ahead and do it. I just hope that I don't spoil this video by doing a repeat. But anyways, so then this is French Exit by Patrick Dewitt, which I read just a few days ago. And while I enjoyed this book, I was thrown off by these blurbs which said it was a madcap caper and witty and stuff like that, because I did not find it to be a madcap dash or a witty, too witty a novel. No, I found it more to be a tragicomedy, and I would say not even a comedy as much as a tragic, sort of that underlying theme of tragedy throughout this book. It didn't turn me off, actually, but it was presented in a way, in a very matter-of-fact kind of way. So I liked it. I liked the writing style. There are these one or two one-liners in this book which are just absolutely great. You just love them. You wonder where the author came up with them. So basically, this is about Francis Price and Malcolm Price, who live in Manhattan, and they're just super rich people, and they have this indolent lifestyle, doing nothing, just going here and there and spending money. And then one day what happens, they're told by the solicitor that your money's run out and you must sell all things which are not locked down and move out of the country. And that's what they do. They go to France. And then French Exit is about, you know, not exiting France per se, but how, you know, they... other things. I can't, you know, just tell you what it means here. But yes, so this is a, I thought this is a good read, and I think it would grow on you on a second read more. But it's very easy if you can finish it in like one sitting, if you have 4 or 5 hours. I finished it in 2 days because I had other things to do in the middle. But yes, I would give it 3.5 stars, a good enough book. And yeah, So then you have The Poppy War by R.F. Kuang. Now this book also I finished a few days ago, even though I'm off fantasy, but I thought I'll give this one a try. So The Poppy War is about Rin, who gives, ace the Keju, which is an entrance exam for administrative or sort of, services in the empire, Chinese empire. And then she is just an orphan, and she lives in a opium den, and not an opium den openly, because obviously the opium is barred in their country. And she is she studies very hard, she clears the exam, and she goes to the best military academy in the country. And there she is bullied, and she learns new things about herself, about craft, and works hard. And really, I felt the beginning part of this book was such a, what you call, when you see, in this, around this time, May, June in India, all the kids are preparing for their entrance examinations, and just after their final school results are out, and the same kind of that anxiety and tension that they've portrayed in the first half of that book, when she's studying to try to get into an academy, and then later trying to catch up with the other students. I really enjoyed that bit. And then of course there is an introduction of the magical element in this whole thing, and I thought that was also fine. I really, really liked this central character of Rin. I thought she was doing great. I was not very impressed by the other character who was partnering her in this book. He just didn't live up to his potential, I think. And of course the ending was a bit haphazard and a bit rushed, sort of. But I thought overall the book was, yes, as a fantasy, it definitely lives up to its potential. I definitely want to find out what happened to Rin in the second half, and to the rest of the group. And I would also like to see this whole romance thing brewing. I don't know where it's going. I thought it was happening one way, and then now, I don't know where it's going. So let's see what happens with that. So The Poppy Wars is definitely another plus good read for me. A good, not 5-star, but I would say definitely 4-star for me. So yes. Then you have, I read 3 books by Tami Hoag. Yes, got it. So all of them are situated in a place called Oak Knoll. I got a bit confused, I thought the detective was somebody else. That's right. Oak Knoll was the name of the place, and the detective is called Vince Leon. He's an FBI profiler who comes to this small town and helps, solve these mysteries. So this Deeper Than the Dead is the first one in this series. Then you have Secrets to the Grave, and then the third one was whatever. Again, forgotten. Down the Darkest Road. I thought all 3 of the books were extremely fast-paced, but they are very, very gory and very, very gruesome. So you better be careful when you pick them up. They're very highly descriptive of the scenes of violence in all of the books, and especially with little children around, it's very difficult to read at times. But yes, I did, and I thought they were okay. They were good, and but I need a break before reading another Tami Hoag, and because I hope that you can't read them at a stretch. Like, there are, I don't know how many of her books out, but they are very, very difficult to read. And obviously the conclusions at the end of each book are pretty good, and you are rooting for the, not just for the main characters, but the other side characters also, and you're drawn in by all of them. So yes, I enjoyed these 3 books also. And then there is the book club read, which I must discuss, which was Cutting for Stone by Abraham Verghese. So this was a story of Marion Stone, and it is narrated by him, and he's telling us about his birth and his childhood and how he came to be where he is in his life. So the book begins with a prologue, which in essence tells the whole story. And when I read that, I was like, if you've told the whole story in these first few pages, what are you going to do for the rest of your 400 so or so pages that you have? It was a bulky book, really bulky. So, but the author manages to capture your interest and hold it for a long time to come. And I thought that was great. I thought the descriptions of the medical procedures in this book are exceptional, especially for people who, even for people who are laymen who would not know medical jargon, they have been described, the procedures have been described in a way which, you know, even everybody found mesmerizing in the book club, most of the people who have never before thought on those things. The descriptions of nature of Ethiopia, the place itself, were beautiful. They brought the whole, a new country to life in front of our eyes. And you could feel the author's love for that country. Somebody pointed out, and which I also realized later on, is when the author moves to America, he never really describes the country, you know, or even the people, you know, because it's as if there is a disconnect. His mind is still in Ethiopia, and you know, it is just beautifully, beautifully captured. It unfolded a history of Ethiopia in a way that, you know, which we found, which most of us were not very cognizant of, obviously. And so this is, the writing style is wonderful. It just draws you in. Marion Stone, as the narrator, does a good job, pronounce it. And the each and every character that the author has portrayed is so strong and so nice and, you know, such vividly drawn and great people. I mean, you almost wish that they had some flaws, but they did not. And the one flawed character which the author has created actually felt forced, actually felt as some character created just to push the story forward. And every time the story took a leap, it was because of this one character. And by the end of it, I think almost everybody was totally disgusted by this character. The only problem I had was with the ending, which I thought just was too predictable for me. Each and every twin book that I have read has ended in just the same way. I wish that the author had gone a different way, but what can you do? So, that is my wrap up. I think I have missed out one book. I think I have missed out Lies Behind the Ruin by Helen Mattews. And if I have, then I'll have to chop up and put it next time. So I have just done this video so many times, I just can't do it again. It's still too long. So, till next time, bye-bye, take care.